The heart lump at the... Yeah, then because when he walks, then it gets trapped underneath his shell.
June 30th, 2006.
Mm. But doesn't like, there's no... I mean, appetite wise is...
Oh, still good, right? Yeah, appetite good. Is good. Stools are okay?
Yeah, everything's like okay. Just when he walks,
it gets still active, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, what food are you feeding now?
Mixed vegetables, sometimes fish, sometimes pellets.
Sometimes fruits. And sometimes fruits.
Fruits. Is this a normal diet? Yeah. Or do you change it in the last 2 years?
It's a meal.
4 years?
Below a bit.
Before that wasn't. Yeah.
Any pellets or not?
Yeah.
What kind of pellets are
there? Those normal, like...
Parmesan, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, any recent trauma? Fall down?
Or stepped on? No.
No history of trauma?
Which part is this talking about?
I think that's like a...
Where, which part?
Because drag on the floor is... Let's
see. The neck, is it?
Yeah.
Oh, the neck. Let's see. Mm. Tail is okay.
I think he's very anxious now.
Yeah.
Otherwise, he can handle it most of the time.
Mm.
You should say it's...
I think if you can press it.
Yeah, there's a lump thing.
Oh, hold for me that neck. Let's see the neck first. Just the neck only.
Okay, so anyway, there are a few possibilities. Okay,
two hands.
For a swelling or for a skin issue, worry about two things. First one is an abscess. Okay, so abscess is, let's say sometimes there's some cut and the bacteria going in, then a bit of discharge, then it's stuck underneath. So you see a bit of a swelling there. Okay, the other thing is cancer. Okay, but cancer usually what happens is breast, it just grows in one area. Okay, so there's two ways to know for sure. Okay, first one is you can take an x-ray. Okay, the x-ray will tell you whether inside is fluid, inside is soft tissue, okay, or what is inside lah. Okay, the second
there's
way
a lump
is
there, yeah.
We can excise it and then send for testing. Means that we need anesthetic, then after that we cut, see what's inside lah. Okay, then if let's say it's a lump or what, can shell out, then we take out. Okay,
it's a lump, yeah. There's a lump there, definitely.
But this one becomes 14 years old, you see. So anesthetic risk is definitely there. So these two ways usually.
A lump is definitely there. There's a lump there. You feel it?
Yeah. There's a small little lump underneath the skin, I agree with you. Okay, but that's a subcutaneous area. So we don't know whether that's actually an abscess capsule, or we don't know whether that is, like what I say,
something went in. How long already?
Many months, yeah, but it grew over the months.
Growing,
The neck.
How come it doesn't have the red Is one not so red now, the
not
ear?
Not very sure, because I always have this question also, like...
Normally they're quite red now. I'll put down first then.
Okay, so then these two methods...
Interesting,
yeah. First one, you want a diagnostic approach, you take an x-ray first though. Okay, the second one is if you just want to go in and see what
surgery
it is, then just cut and see. Oh, by
let me take a photo. Yeah. Ready? Take them first.
Can I also check, like, because the sides, the skin are a little bit, like, coming out, so...
Mm-hmm.
So,
any bleeding?
Just one.
Or below?
But sometimes it's in and out, so...
Yeah, because you used to be quite fat, right?
Yeah.
That's the reason.
Is that fat?
A human being, when you lose weight, you got a bit of sagging in tummy and all this. Any lump or not?
A little.
I think have also.
Is there another therapy in the home?
No.
No more, yeah.
Just him.
Normally it's due to his loose weight.
Fat.
Lose a lot of weight. This one should be more than 900 grams, right? Should be more than 900 grams.
Both sides also, is it?
Very small. This one.
No, this subcutaneous fat.
Yeah, fat. Yeah. He lost a lot of weight.
Subcutaneous fat.
This one should be at least 1.5.
Only this one is a bit harder. You can see that there's some infection on the skin also. Can you see scab?
He's been scratching. Has he been scratching?
Never. He just keep rubbing on the floor.
Yeah, he did.
So sometimes, also, you know, like, If let's say you do cross
rubbing
too much, then you get a callus because of abrasion.
Yeah. Irritation, yeah.
So we don't know whether this one could be abrasion also. But we can, if it is abrasion, then it's just healing tissue underneath.
Yeah.
Okay, basically there was an injury, so the body's trying to heal it up. Okay, so I mean,
we can try the other one.
If you want,
steroid.
We can give some medications first all, which is your anti-inflammatories. And then we give you a wash to make sure that all the infection is gone from here. And if let's say your swelling goes down, then nothing really. Okay, but if not, then you still have to take an x-ray. Because we don't know whether that healing tissue is soft tissue swelling due to cancer, or it's just normal healing tissue.
Yeah.
Okay?
If you want, then just remove it.
Yeah.
Go under the... But you will must be aware of the risk, like anesthetic. You know, we just go open and then just take out the lump.
But easy to look after now, really.
And then after the surgery?
Normally we just stitch up now.
Oh.
And then it heals quickly?
Still have to...
Depends on this therapy, because how often is it in the water? How many hours a day?
About 10 hours, 12 hours.
Then you have to restrict the...
Oh.
Now we put him less in the water, we let him walk in the house. So he...
He's a beautiful...
Maybe less than 10.
You want to try the medication and the cream first?
Yeah. Maybe we try that first.
Okay.